In an authorization, the Expenses module lets you estimate your expected travel reimbursable expenses and calculate your anticipated mileage allowances. Accurately predicting your trip expenses and allowances provides an accurate should-cost estimate for your trip. Receipts are not required for estimated expenses on the authorization, but your organization may require additional documentation. Please check with your Defense Travel Administrator for further guidance on any required documentation.
A new feature that was deployed with the FY20 expenses release is the What's New pop-up. Whenever a new release is deployed, users will be presented with the What's New pop-up explaining what has changed in this particular part of DTS. The system will look at the user's login information and will only present the user with this one time. When the user selects Got It, the system will not present this user with a pop-up again. However, if the user selects the X, the next time they navigate to that particular page, they will be presented with the What's New pop-up again. The FY20 expenses release combined the trip workbook, reservation expenses, other expenses, and substantiating documents into one expenses page with new intuitive features. Users can navigate to the expenses module by selecting expenses from the navigation or progress bar. All expenses will be collapsed and displayed in a default order that can be modified by selecting the Sort By feature at the top. The Expenses page contains all the expenses in the document, including reservations, per diem, and other types of expenses. Each expense is displayed as a card that is defaulted to a collapsed view. Users can select Details to view more information about each expense. They can also select the Expand All button at the top to expand all the expense cards at once. Selecting Expand All will change the button to Collapse All. The Add button gives the user the ability to add expenses, upload documents or PDFs, and on vouchers, import government charge card transactions. There are 7 categories to choose from on an authorization: international travel expenses, lodging expenses, mileage expenses, other expenses, ticketed expenses, transportation expenses, and documents. For each expense or document that is added, the user will have the ability to type in information about the expense or that document in the notes section. This gives more insight to routing officials on what each expense is. Notes are visible to anyone in the Expenses section by expanding the details and selecting Notes. They can be modified while in the Edit mode. To remove an existing item from the Expenses section, the user can select the three dots to the right and then select Delete Expense. To duplicate an expense, the user can select the three dots and then select Duplicate Expense. This is useful when you want to create a round-trip expense. DTS will automatically create an identical expense. The user should then modify the dates, details, and notes prior to selecting Add. In this example, the user forgot to modify the notes. This is an easy fix. Simply expand the details, go to the notes, make the modifications, and then select Update. On an authorization, you should enter all the expenses you think you may encounter while on your trip. The Add box also allows for you to search for a particular expense or document by typing into the dropdown. The authorization is an estimate of expenses that the traveler will encounter while on their trip. For expenses like lodging taxes, CONUS, and non-foreign, if the user does not know the amount, they should make an educated estimate. Typically, lodging taxes are between 10 to 20% of the nightly lodging cost. For this example, the nightly lodging cost is $119. 15% of 119 is $17.85. Take that over 4 nights and it becomes $71.40. A nice round estimate for this amount would be about $75. Lodging taxes are not reimbursable for OCONUS locations, as they are included in the lodging amount of the per diem. Even for CONUS and non-foreign OCONUS, lodging taxes may or may not be charged by your hotel. You should check with the GSA website to see if the state you're traveling to is a tax-exempt state and if any forms are required. When in doubt about the estimated amount you may be charged, contact the hotel for more information. There are several ways to attach documents to the expenses page. Attaching documents on an authorization may or may not be required. Examples of required documentation include, but are not limited to, constructed travel worksheets when the distance is greater than 400 miles one way or 800 miles round trip, and documents required by your organization's local business rules. If you are unsure of what documents to include, you should contact your Defense Travel Administrator for further guidance. Documents can be added by using the Add button and then scrolling to the bottom of the list and selecting Documents. The user can then choose the type of document they are uploading before continuing. If they do not see their type of document, they should select Other. After choosing the type of document, the user should then select Attach Document. PDF files will be automatically converted into picture files. This allows for other users to view the document without having to download the file. If the document needs to retain its PDF integrity, for example, a constructed travel worksheet or digitally signed file, users can check this box. Once a file has been attached, the system will display view attachments with the number of pictures uploaded. Whenever an attachment has been associated to an expense or document, the user will have the ability to view, zoom, rotate, and download. The user will also have the ability to delete the attachment while in edit mode. Another way to upload a document is by using the Import PDF button. This feature only searches for PDF files. After a quick conversion to a picture, the user can then choose which pages they would like to import. There is an ability to switch between list and grid view, which will either display more information for each page or display more pages in general. At this point, the user can choose which page they would like to upload by selecting the checkbox next to each page or by choosing all pages at the top. When importing a PDF, the option is available to associate the attachment directly to an existing expense, to create a new expense, or to create a new document. The Import PDF feature will then return the user back to their list of pages that were imported. Pages that have been attached already to a document or expense will be green and display the word attached. At this point, the user can choose the next set of pages to attach or select Done. Attachments can also be added by expanding any expense. Users have the ability to drag and drop or browse for a document to upload. Simply select the Browse button or the plus icon to begin. Whenever there is at least one attachment that has been uploaded, users will receive a Download All button. Selecting Download All will download a zip file to the user's computer with all the attachments. This function is useful for routing officials who would prefer to have all the attachments in one place. Any lodging expense or expense of $75 or more requires a receipt and will have an icon next to it. On an authorization, this is a reminder to obtain a receipt. On a voucher, this is a requirement. The lodging expense card will pull lodging amounts from the per diem entitlement section of the document. These amounts cannot be modified on this page. The user has the option to edit per diem by selecting the three dots. This will take the user to the per diem entitlements page. Changes made in the per diem entitlements will reflect in the expenses page. Notice that the lodging cost and the lodging allowed differ. This is due to the lodging in the document being part of the integrated lodging program, so the lodging allowed is limited to the maximum DOD preferred rate. Since the traveler is only entitled to the allowed rate, $121.50 displays for each day, rather than the lodging cost of $135. Resetting the per diem will change the amounts back to the amount the traveler booked initially in the document. When all the expenses have been added, the user should select Continue to move on to the next module.